companies going to make it?
Absolutely.
Yes.
Yep.
Okay, and do you have any thoughts on Gary, by the way? Do either of you know Mr. Wagner, any of you?
I've met Mr. Wagner a few times.
I've met Mr. Wagner, yes.
What was he, how was he like with vis-a-vis employees?
Go ahead, Mike.
I met him when he came to Lansing, Michigan here when they started the LGR plant, and very personal guy and talkative and seemed like a real decent guy.
Pretty much my sentiment. He was a very nice gentleman.
Well, you've been nice enough to hang tough. I hope you get back to work, Roland.
Thank you, Larry.
Mike, keep up the tough fight. And Gary, best of luck in retirement.
Thank you, Larry.
Thanks.
Mike Green, Roland Green, and Gary Knapp. Your blog comments are next. CNN.com/Larry King. Stick around.
It's clear we need more energy from...
To bail or not to bail, that seems to be the question. At least that's the question of the day on our blog. David Thale, what are the people saying tonight?
Larry, we asked this question of the day. Should the government bail out struggling businesses? We're hearing a lot of no's. There's some talk in the blog tonight about whether or not the government should step in and fire the GM CEO, but most of the people are answering the question that we asked, and they're saying no. Somebody says enough is enough. We pulled this one for you, Larry. Somebody said, at first, I believed these companies were too big to fail. At first, he says, I no longer do. That's the way the conversation is looking this time of night, Larry, on the blog.
And David, usually when we talk about the auto industry help on the blog, people seem genuinely concerned about the worker. Is that holding out?
That tonight is no exception. People will criticize the government. They will criticize the auto industry, but they usually go to bat for the U.S. auto worker. Somebody like this, Alex, on that said, I hate giving one dime to GM to the GM machine. Unfortunately, if we don't, it's the auto worker who'll pay the heaviest cost, says Alex. This conversation continues as it always does. CNN.com/Larry King. Look for the blog link. Click it. Jump into the conversation. Larry and I always love hearing from you.
You bet, David. Thanks so much. Congressman McCotter, the union member, said that don't blame them so much. They were making cars that the public wanted. How do you react to that?
Well, they were making cars that the public wanted, and even the quality gap, according to most objective observers, has been closed, if not surpassed. And so I think that when you see people like Mr. Knapp, the new retiree, and both Greens, who are now a family legacy in that industry, you can see that these are the best workers in the world. They take an enormous amount of pride in what they do, and they show a lot of dedication to it, and it is reflected in the product. And I'm most heartened to hear that your viewers understand that these workers are the ones who are going to pay the price for any restructuring in the future, and that's why they need our help.
Nobody, Judge Mathis, is blaming the workers. Are they?
And they shouldn't. You know, as the worker just said, they're making cars that the public wanted. Unfortunately, with the oil crisis, you know, the oil companies make record profits and the oil prices go up at record amounts. And so the attitudes and the taste of the consumer changed then. But when the oil was stable, then of course there was demand for the best cars. And so when the oil market became unstable, they had to change their taste.
Ed, do you think the industry is ever going to come around to the kind of thinking you have?
I hope they do, not just that I have, that many other people have. You know, they fought the CAFE standards for a year, the high mile per gallon. They fought the seat belts. They fought the airbags. They fought the smog control devices. We have four times the cars in L.A. right now since 1978. We have half the smog because of those pollution control devices. We have 500 at the low end, $700 billion a year leaves this country, according to me and T. Boone Pickens, that's leaving this country in imported oil. We'd have more money now to deal with those problems if we made higher mile per gallon vehicles.
But they fight it.
They fight it. And again, 30 is great. I've gotten 58.6 real-world miles per gallon my wife's Prius. That's the kind of car. They have had waiting lists for those cars, Larry. I think Detroit wants waiting lists.
How many do they make?
They've made a lot of Priuses. They've sold now a tremendous amount of Prius cars.
Mayor Newsom, do you have faith in the industry?
Well, Larry, it's interesting. Ed brings up 30 miles a gallon. I mean, the 1908, the Model T Ford was getting 25 miles a gallon. I mean, think about that. Here we are a century later. How much progress have we made? It's true. Mike was right to suggest that we were building cars that the customers wanted, but I don't know that we knew what we wanted. I much prefer a car that gets 100 miles a gallon, but I was never even afforded the opportunity to think differently and then act differently when I was in the showroom. Company out here in the Bay Area, Tesla Motors, just created these new electric vehicles, one of the fastest cars in the world. I didn't know that technology existed until I got in and drove one. The reality is we need to dramatically dramatically reinvent, reconsider, refocus, recalibrate our expectations of what the automobile industry is going to look like 5-10 years from now, not play in the margins. And I think that's what President Obama was speaking to. There's some good things happening in the automobile industry, but good is not good enough in this economic climate.
So, Congressman, in your judgment, where's it all going?
I think the Greens were right. I think Mr. Knapp was right. That despite many of the misperceptions that are out there and the difficult challenges and circumstances in which the auto companies find themselves here in the United States, precisely because of the workers, precisely because of the pride they take in the craft and the product that they put out, these companies are going to make it, and it's because of the workers.
By the way, Judge, one of Judge Mathis's platforms is advising young people on how to expunge past convictions and provide legal resources. And for information, check out Ask Judge Mathis. That's all one word. AskJudgeMathis.com.
Thank you for the commercial.
Where do you think it's going?
Well, unfortunately, I don't see much compassion coming from Washington, not the same type of compassion they've shown. No, not the same type they've shown that to the banking system. You don't see a CFO there or a CEO there being ousted as a condition of money. And I see them, quite frankly, trying to drive them toward bankruptcy. And if that happens, so that they can get more control. But they don't understand if that happens, no one will buy another car.
Ed, do you think Wall Street gets a better break than the auto?
Well, I think, $28.4 billion is a lot of compassion. But I want to save those workers there. That's my main goal, to save them, to be making cars, fuel-efficient cars, cars that people want, and making things for wind turbines like Roush and PAS are doing now for this company, Enviro Energies. You can do things other than just make cars there. Clean tech, I think, is going to be a big part of our future.
And Mayor Newsom,
yeah, go ahead, Mayor.
Yeah, may I just jump in? Let's not talk about saving these jobs. Let's talk about creating the jobs of the future. I mean, the reality is we have a limitless capacity if we reinvent this industry, plug in hybrid technology, purely electric technology, rethinking the way we deliver the vehicle along the lines of the way, for example, we deliver phone service. You can pay by the minute, you can pay by the mile. Reinventing this system. There's so many new programs and proposals out there. Better Place, a company out here in the Bay Area, is doing just that in Israel, in Denmark, and Australia. We have to reinvent and reimagine and not just play on defense, but now start to play on the offensive.
Thank you all very much. Congressman Thaddeus McCotter, Ed Begley Jr., Judge Greg Mathis, and Mayor Gavin Newsom. This is a continuing story, and we appreciate you coming by tonight. Madonna wants to adopt another child. So why does the whole world have something seemingly to say about it? That's next.